everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Enigma and you're watching Enigma Inc. So let's do Gemini. Okay, this is going to be a general reading. Take what resonates, leave what does not. For personal readings and more accuracy, you can book me on WhatsApp or Instagram me. Details are given below. My magical workshop is on heavy discount, which is on $66 only, and it's a very, very powerful workshop. And many people have manifested great results. You can check out reviews on Instagram. So it's a Guru Purnima discount, which is on 22nd of July. So all those who wants to avail this offer, you can WhatsApp us or email also, Instagram. You can send me a message on Instagram. So we'll give you more details about it. Okay. And do subscribe to my channel for more videos on Gemini and other signs. Follow me on Instagram for all the updates, offers, guidance, and much more. Gemini, what's coming up? Gemini, please. All right, Gemini. Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus signs. Okay. Oh my God. You're very passionate and action oriented about money. I feel like Gemini, money is right now very, very important goal for you, and you're going uphill for it. Okay. So you're working hard and hard on it, and I feel like your masculinity is dominating your femininity. That means you're focused on being more independent, doing things all by yourself, and being a, you know, lion in the field. I see a lot of money coming in, making a lot of friends. Okay, your family is happy with you, and you feel very rooted, and you have, you know, it's kind of, you feel like you've set a stable foundation for yourself, and you can sleep on it very relaxed, very happy, and you are successful, and you feel like, you know, you're like you know, admiring yourself, your abilities, or whatever you have achieved till now. So you're feeling very proud of yourself in that ways. Okay, you feel very cozy. You may be buying a new house also, thinking of one. And I also feel with the force was that you don't want to, you know, put your time and energy, it's like a waste for you if you right now focus on love situation. So you are very protective of your heart, and you want to discover more opportunities in love when it comes to that. And I feel like you're having more opportunities to travel to places or find out more work opportunities. And you're also looking for a lover outside your city or your country, you know, like that. You want someone from a different race, background, culture, you know, like that. You want to discover places, you want to go out and explore, you know, not just in career but also in love situation. Right now you feel very independent, stable, loved. Okay, you are enjoying your finances, you are enjoying your own energy. I feel like you feel like you're very stable and secure in your own energy. This brings up your confidence to another level. You are growing and glowing, and I feel like you may be, you know, with these trees. Do you see these trees? This got my eye, which is telling me that these tree, I think these are called whistling trees. I don't remember exactly, but this is telling me that you're living in a very cold place or a hilly area where there are a lot of mountains, you know, or you want to go there and just relax, have your, you know, sip of tea and just, you know, watch your favorite movie. And with this red, the red is signifying here that your fire energy is at peak. That means you're feeling very, very stable, grounded, lot of money coming in, and you can build a whole house of it, you know, like you can buy a dream house of it, you know, like that. You're very close to your goal. That's how you feel. Gemini, please. Some of you, when it comes to love situation, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, or Aries, Sagittarius, Leo feels very, very attracted to you, and they may be asking you for a solid commitment. However, your focus is on self, but you're not ignoring opportunities also in love. Okay, so here I see that you have struggled a lot in your work till now, maybe 3 years, 3 months, something on those lines. You struggled a lot. So again, the hills are telling me that you may be somewhere from those areas. And I feel like you may be shifting to a new place also. That is also coming off very strongly. Or you're thinking about that. Maybe for a job, you're getting a job at a place where you have to go from your place. You have to go away from your place. And you may have to travel a long distance. Okay, maybe 3 hours. Or it may take 3 days for you to travel from one place to another for that dream job that you're getting. Whatever it is, your money is growing, okay? And you are going to make a team as well. You're the leader here. See, now I get the Two of Pentacles here, which is telling me that. I'll take this card back. So the Two of Pentacles over here is telling me that you have a lot of tasks in hand and you are trying to manage, you know, trying to balance those things, okay? And I feel like a lot of opportunities at job, at work, making money is striking your mind. You have new ideas and you're putting them one after the other. And then there are people who are supporting you at the same time. I feel sometimes you get overwhelmed because there's so much of things. And then sometimes you go down phase, okay? But then you try to bring yourself up by balancing things, okay? So it's like a balancing act for you every time. Now here I get a tower card. Now let me see what does this signify to me, the tower thing. Okay, the Two of Swords were telling me that. Now here also, again, I feel like the Ten of Swords and the Tower is telling me to be very careful while managing your finances, because somewhere you may be, you may get into debt or someone may deceive you regarding the money thing, okay? So you have to be very careful of your finances. You may have to invest right away or invest very safely, very securely, or saving is a better option right now for you. Because I do see there may be a warning sign from the angels that you may go into debt. So be very careful that sometimes it's a high life. Sometimes you have to go downhill also. So it's just a part of life. So always prepare yourself for that. So keep your finances always balanced. Alright. What else do I see here? Okay. Alright. So I see there's a new opportunity in love happening. Like you may get into a relationship. Not a marriage exactly. But yes, there's a lover that's reaching out to you. Wanting for something. Like they want to be with you right now. I won't say like a solid commitment for now. But yes, there is this someone who may feel like you are the soulmate. And they want to explore more with you. So they may take you out to places and date for dates and everything. You may have a lot of fun with this person. They will, make you enjoy it to the point you never thought. And I feel like you're ready to manifest things back again. You will come back into light again. I feel like there will be a low point, or there has been some low points in the middle. Maybe because of the love situation. But then you always bring yourself back into picture. And I feel like you're in limelight. You may be doing something great. People are listening to you, following you, like that. And I feel like you're growing also. So you're embracing yourself the way you are. You're openly expressing who you are. And I feel like you're in a verge of manifesting a lot of things that you want for yourself. Some of you dealing with the Sagittarius, Gemini, Aries, Leos, okay? I do see like you may be manifesting success and fame. Yes, that's the idea that I'm getting here. You're manifesting a lot of things. Your special manifestation goes towards fame and success. Let go of control issues. Somewhere you're trying to control yourself. Maybe the past relationship, past wounds. Okay, that is controlling you from reaching where you are at your highest potential. Maybe there's something else that's stopping you, pulling you back. So don't try to control yourself, okay? Maybe you're getting an offer that may be from a different place, okay? From a different city, okay? That may require you to think too much. But if it's a good opportunity, go for it, trust it. Even in love situation, someone will expect you to trust them, okay? Because this person can make your life magical. You really need to free yourself from a wounded energy from the past or a person that's continuously poking you time and again or coming back into your life. Past life. As I told you, there's a past life relationship that you still need to leave or heal yourself from, because this person's continuously coming back and forth, okay, and this is affecting you because this person is all the time asking you for another chance, but then you have to, you know, fix this up and move on because time is less and you have a lot of things to do, isn't it, Gemini? Let me see what next do I have here. To be fair with yourself, have self-respect, try to make things balanced because maybe you are giving too much in a connection and that person is just enjoying the fruit. So you have to be on the other side, okay, not being too giving. Serenity, yes, serendipity. I feel like you need to surrender yourself and let it go, okay. Whatever is meant for you is going to come towards you. I see a lot of money coming in and I see a lot of numbers, synchronicities. You see maybe 11-11. And breathe. I feel like sometimes there's a low point, you just need to relax and, you know, whiff off the negative energy sometimes, you know, everything is fine and fair, don't worry too much. And yeah, some breathing exercise, I really want to keep you uplifted. What else do we have? Some of you are at 29 here, 38 here, 18. Discipline. You need to be focused and consistent at your work, then you're reaching where you want to be. Now let's see from Aries to Pisces, their love for you. Person's love towards you. Aries to Pisces. Aries wants to end this. They're moving on. Taurus. Oh my God. Taurus sees you in a very powerful energy. They feel like they're no match in front of you. You're just above their league. Gemini, this could be your energy as well. Someone wants to marry you or keeping a strong eye on you. They want you. Cancer. Okay, Cancer wants to marry you too. Alright, Cancer wants to marry you. Clearly, they want a stable commitment. Leo is in love with you. They want commitment. Okay, but I feel like Gemini, you're not giving them a chance, which is stressing them too much. Or they want to really be, you know, be that helpful friend that can turn into a lover. Virgo is over because they feel like you're always thinking about money and you don't care about them. Libra wants equal give and take in love and they see you as a wish fulfillment. They don't want to be a friend, they want to be more than that. Scorpio loves you, okay, but Scorpio is fearful because they feel like, I feel like they have a lot of anxieties because of which they cannot openly love you. Although they want to, but they don't know how, so this is kind of depressing this person, so they're leaving the situation. Sagittarius. Or you had someone else, so this person's leaving. Sagittarius. Okay, Sagittarius is letting it go because they feel like this is too much work to convince you. Maybe you want to break their heart, so they're, just for the ego's sake, they're leaving. Capricorn is in love. They're regretting losing you. Now they're continuously stalking you. Okay, Aquarius. Aquarius is highly attracted to you, the way you talk, especially the communication is very powerful. And I feel like it's like a sudden, you know, breakthrough. Like they have never seen someone like you. That's what they want to say. Pisces. Okay, Pisces is very manipulative and like a mature person. I feel like this person is just playing mind games, too many mind games, and this is stressing you. And I feel like the Pisces always wants to create mess in your life, whereas you always want to come off clean and clear. So yeah, that's about it, Gemini. I hope you've enjoyed it. Do not forget to like, share, subscribe, hit the bell. Comment is must. Let me know how this resonated and do like it to ensure that you want more such videos. Bye.